In this clip, we look at the question of what is money, and this is a very important question because the fact that banks deal with money distinguishes banks from any other corporation or business in the economic system. The fact that banks deal with money, it makes banks different and really relevant. And the answer to this question, what is money, is obviously broad. There are libraries of books written about this question, and in this clip we want to focus this answer. So there are different ways to approach this question. You know, you can give a philosophical answer, you can look into economic theory, you can give a technical answer. Money comes in different forms. There are digital forms of money, there's cash money. But let's start with looking at the standard definition of money. So money is a tool. Money is a tool that helps us to measure value. It's a tool that allows us to exchange products and services, and it's a tool to store value. So these three elements, storing value, exchanging services and goods, and measuring values, are a good starting point to understand what money is. But then the question is, what is the value? Where does the value come from? And money today is fiat money, so money is not backed by physical values like gold, but money is backed by the government and issued by the central bank. So what that means is that we basically believe in money. So the value of money has to do with our trust in the government, our trust in the economic system. And as you see, this creates a very rare and distinct situation, because you know, in the rest of our economy we assess the value of a product, we assess the value of a service, but in the core of our economic system sits a tool that generates its values from our trust and belief in our economic system as a whole. And the core tool of our economic system, money, is basically a legal construct. So money sits at the edge between our economic system and our political system. And this fact itself differentiates money from any other tool in our economic system, and this fact that money is a legal construct has an implication on the role of banks in our system. So money is fiat money. That means the value of money is given, it's basically backed by the government and the economic system as a whole. But in order to understand what money is, we think we need to get further into detail here. So what actually happens when you give money from one, or handle money from one person to another? So let's just look at that. So if you have, you know, euro or dollar in your hands and you give money, just imagine you give the money to a person next to you. What happens? In that moment, the person looks at you and says, why? So what's the reason? Why do you transfer money to me? And that simple gesture alone explains what money does. So basically, money creates a relationship. The moment money transfers from one person to another person, you create a relationship between these two people. And then the question is, what type of relationships? And we would like to look at three possible answers to this. So the first one is, I give you the 10 euro and you give me your pen. So this is basically an exchange of values. And if we both accept the values, we are happy and this exchange is completed. So that's easy, the relationship is over. Or I give you the 20 bucks and I want you, because you asked for it, you need a loan, you need the money. And you promise me to give it back later. So this is a loan, and this is very important when you talk about values-based banking to understand what's the core character of a loan. And what we want to emphasize here is that the moment you give someone a loan, the relationship continues. So when I buy this pen, the relationship is over. But the moment I give you money as loan money, I want to know, what do you want to do with this? Why do you need it? When do I get it back? So the quality of my relationship to you differs. And that's really important when it comes to values-based banking. So when I buy something, the relationship is over. The moment I give you a loan, the relationship continues. And I'm interested in the quality and content of what you are planning to do with this. And there's a third form of relationship that can exist when I transfer money. Do you have a suggestion here? So it's that I just give you the money. So I give it away. It's a gift from me to you. And we often don't consider gifts as part of our economic thinking. But when you, for example, look here at MIT, you see that gift money is really relevant. Research and development is basically gift money. So gift money is money that's given to enable someone to do something without a clear contract of what the result will be. So gift money enables, and gift money is important in our economic system because it creates innovation and new ideas. And so in summary, what we think is really important to understand about money is, first, money is a legal construct. So money sits between the government, political system, and the economic system, and that's why banks have such a special role in our economies. And then there's a definition of money, what money does, storing value, helping us with exchange, measuring value. Then we work with fiat money in our economies today, so there's no backup by physical values, but the backup is basically our belief in our government and our economic system. And thirdly, the transaction of money, giving money from one person to another, creates a relationship. And there are three types of relationships, and all three are relevant in our economic system. And the awareness of these three relationships is really important for values-based banking.